Check, check. One monitor, sir.
That's good.
Oh, yeah.
You need a little better? Kevin, you just get some of these. That's what you get.
Concerned about the parking lot now because I just saw the other guy with the jaywalking. He just did it again. Jaywalking. And again. Jaywalking. He's not learning. Jaywalking. Right after you just told him.
Is it possible to have a little white light over here? Not at all. Should we just do no lights, maybe? Or house lights on?
I can't see my friend.
Yeah, friend.
Oh, there.
There they go. Maybe we just do, like, all white instead
drop
of the stage
bag.
Lights.
Put your hands behind your back. Okay, I'll just turn.
This is Johnny Jermaine Rush. Sonny Spitz, San Francisco. One of the first rappers that wrote to us from Represa, California, for the project Anti-Repression Music. He said, go ahead and use this track. Well, he just sent the lyrics to this song, actually, that you're listening to right now. He sent the lyrics for it. He said, go ahead and use it however. He said, look it up on YouTube, play it for the people. I said, all right.
What's wrong with you? What the fuck is wrong with you? I don't know what your problem is. I don't know if you got a gun. I don't know if you got a knife.
How?
I don't have X-ray fucking vision.
Hey, man, stop yelling at me.
Well, get up and put you in a car, tough boy. Do anything stupid, you're going to get hurt further. Look at me with your spitty blood face. Tried to drag the taser out of my hand, and I just went on his f***ing head. I beat the shit out of his head. I'm not gonna lie about that.
We system that says that wealth and inequality is because some people are more qualified than others, not because of the failure of market forces, then the solution is forcing those who are on the losing end to behave themselves and accept their diminished position. Because if we were to admit that market forces had something to do with this rise in inequality, then we'd have to do something about those market forces.
Yeah. Superior to mine. Mine was as the taper light. His was as the burning sun. I could live for the slave. John Brown could die for me.
Thank you.
Well done. Oh.
Alright, so we put out a zine. The Sacred Lines from Hell has all the lyrics that you're hearing tonight. And an explanation of where we are. Pick them up for free, right here. Anytime.
Is it actually possible to have an egalitarian society where human needs are met and realized, where the destruction of the planet isn't connected to the way that our lives are organized, where racism and sexism and transphobia and oppressions that exist in the society, are these things, the absence of these things, actually compatible in a free market capitalist system? Free market capitalist system. Free market capitalist system. We're among friends.
means necessary. By all means necessary. By all means necessary. Table, nothing for sale, everything, pick it up, stickers free, alright, information, always free, more than you can find out on the internet.
Hey everybody, for you, I just want to point out what this is all about today. I am exhausted, by the way. know, so the funds that are coming from today are split between IWOC and ABO Comics. IWOC distributes to prisoners facing retaliation from the prison strikes, and ABO Comics gives direct aid to LGBTQ prisoners. So back there, you'll see ABO Comics selling the zines and other stuff. All the funds go to the LGBTQ prisoners. Black and Pink is also back there as well. And we also have merch from the bands who so graciously donated their time for tonight. So definitely check out their stuff, for sure. Yeah, thank you guys, by the way. Yeah, give it up for, yeah, give it up for Digi Decarcerated. That was really awesome. Always enjoy it. But yeah, out front also, because we've got just so many tables going on. Out front, we have PM Press with a bunch of really rad books. And also we have Sarah, who's got some really awesome patches and prints that you guys should check out. And yeah, I wanted to say also thank you to 1234Go for always graciously hosting us and supporting our work. That is very awesome of them. And also, yeah, thank you to all of you for coming out. Like, yeah, if you're as tired as I am, you're awesome. And then, yeah, basically, like, also, so the prison strike, it was a, it was resulting to something that happened on April 15th at the Lee Correctional Institution, where prisoners were locked in various units for hours, where deadly fights broke out, and guards refused to break up fights and refused to give medical care. It's really fucked up way to treat people. So definitely very important to look into that. Or if anybody has any questions, you know, we've got a bunch of resources. I read a quote today, like from an interview that I was reading from incarceratedworkers.org that really stuck with me. But it's, people are not born criminals. They're criminalized by the environments that they are socialized within. And I think that's really important to remember that. I don't think people are ever born bad. You know, we need to support each other and not punish each other. So yeah, support everybody here. You know, thank you for coming out. Thank you for your donations. And yeah, thank you to the bands that are playing. I think next we have Diatomaceous Earth, which I'm stoked for. Cool. Thank you guys.
Thank you.